Arsenic is a naturally occurring substance. It occurs in groundwater, and typically it occurs naturally, but it can also be seen as a result of some human activities such as mining. It's a problem in water because it affects human health and it can limit the use of some potentially usable water sources. Arsenic is a problematic constituent worldwide.
Arsenic happens over time as the degradation of minerals contaminated into your water source, but it can be hyper-localized. You can have one well that is perfectly fine and 100 meters away a second well that's contaminated with arsenic. If you go back and check 6 months later or 2 years later, you could find that both wells are contaminated, or you could still have the exact same situation.
Arsenic is known to cause serious health issues, both in adults and in children. It's known to cause a variety of cancers related to skin, bladder, lungs, liver, as well as heart disease.
EPA has determined arsenic is found more in groundwater sources compared to the surface water sources such as lakes and rivers. The U.S. Geological Survey has found high concentrations of arsenic in the western part of the country, in Midwest, and in the New England area.
A lot of the technology that we're using now, while robust and while it provides accurate data, can be expensive, and there can also be delays between when a sample is collected and when data becomes available, which makes it difficult to rely on that technology for making real-time decisions.
Current arsenic sensors that are commercially available are not as accurate at the lower levels, especially around the safe levels. And additionally, they produce arsane gas, which is considered a toxic.
Lower cost real-time arsenic sensors can enable us to better characterize source waters for future development.
I think another element that would be very interesting for this challenge is how we can use cell phones or mobile technologies, new apps, to be able to improve how we test in the field.
I think that there are a lot of great ideas for better ways to measure arsenic in water than we and the government have been able to put into practice. Arsenic in water is a widespread challenge that many people are thinking about, and a challenge gives us the opportunity to raise attention around this issue and ask everyone for their best ideas on how to address it.
In terms of the test kits that are used in the field, those don't have quite the accuracy that a laboratory analysis does, but it does give you a real-time result. So a rapid, low-cost way to measure arsenic would enable water managers to ensure that water delivered to the public is safe and affordable.
We're working with a big group of collaborators on this challenge.
I think the thing I'm most excited about for this arsenic challenge is seeing how people are going to innovate and iterate on existing technology.